Good morning, YouTube. Well, actually, it's evening, kind of late in the evening. So we got my car. We got Stu's 360, and we got like everyone's here. So it's gonna be a beer drinking good time. We're gonna change the oil in Stu's car and probably do the brake fluid too. Stu's gonna do it.
I'm gonna do it.
He's gonna do it. I see. Like, I'm gonna wear my nice seat. I'm gonna wear my nice shirt, which you can buy, by the way. You can buy this. Oh, look at he's getting suited up. That's a really nice shirt. Well, he's still wearing a loafer too. Yeah. All right, so let's do that. Let's get Stu's car back in good order. It's a long way down the Holiday Road. You get to do
jack your shit.
So there should be a jack point somewhere under there. Like, it's probably right here, but you're gonna have to find it. And it's probably like a little circle in your panel.
I fucking swapped out his wheels for him while he stood there and polished the vehicle.
Dude, he was a champ. He did it in 22 minutes.
All right, get out from under there so I'm not jacking it and killing you. All right, heave ho, bitch. Heave ho. You get the sweat. I'm gonna stand here.
Mm-hmm.
So I personally think the easiest thing to do with these is jack it up, then put wheel ramps under the rear wheels. So that's what we're doing. Instead of trying to like fart around with trying to get it on the ramps, like backing up, it's just easier this way.
All right, what do we got under here?
Oh, you have like actual screws. So technically yours, like mine, you don't have to pull the panel. It's up to you if you wanna pull the panel or not.
It should be easier to access everything.
It's easier to get access if you pull the panel. Yeah. It just takes more time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's do it.
All right, so it's just a bunch of Phillips screws.
Mind the viewers that we are doing this not in the summer months, but in the fall.
Yeah, because it's not so ridiculously hot.
Should I check on him or leave him to his own devices? All right, I'll check on him.
How you doing, Stu?
I am oh man, I got
the bolts. Oh yeah, look at all those bolts. All right, so it's a totally different panel than the 430, which is interesting. It's got it's a similar design up here, totally different design back there. Fun.
Fun.
Fun stuff. Still got a bolt up here. Here, hand me the 10 mil. There's still a bolt.
All right, yeah, hold on, I got to move. I'll slide it over.
All right.
Yeah, there's one here too. Okay. There.
Got it. I think there's some more bolts. Oh, there is, I see it. Okay, hold on, damn it. All right, there it is. I think that's the last bolt. We hope.
Yeah, I think so, because I think it's...
It's starting to move a lot. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Be careful when it comes, it doesn't fall on your hand and smash you. It's not that heavy.
I don't mind the hand. I just don't want the... I don't want to fall on this pretty face.
Don't fall on the moneymaker.
Yeah.
Actually, it should kind of...
Here. Hold on. Here's the bolt.
There
okay.
We go.
All right. Slide that this way.
It may have to go back a little, but I think there's still a bolt. I can tell there is. I think you just gotta loosen it.
I think if you loosen it, you should just kind of be able to pull it down. It will bend, you know, and then pop out. There we go. There it is.
Woo! Victory.
This is documenting that you really can do work on your own vehicle, save a ton of money, so that you can go out having fun burning it in gas.
Yeah.
And
beer.
Beer.
American.
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 Fuck yeah.
So we got the panel out, and now we're just jacking the car up a little higher. So the big question is, do we want to do the brakes too tonight? If we do, then we should put up all four corners and just, while we got it up in the air, we'll just take off all four wheels and...
Let's do it.
All right.
All right, so we're gonna actually jack up the entire car so it's really up in the air. That way we can do the brakes in a little bit too. Where Stu's all nervous. He's like, my poor baby. My baby's flying!
We got jacked up on all four corners. We're gonna take off all the wheels. So we can do that. So we'll take off the wheels at the same time we're doing the oil, basically. We'll double team this motherfucker.
Tag team.
Tag team this bitch.
Eiffel Tower.
Yeah!
Yeah!
The loafer. The sideways loafer, there it is. Yeah!
There. Well, the parking brake's on. The rears are easy.
It's the front that's gonna be
spin the globe.
Yeah.
Get in that brake. There it goes.
Oh my god, the bikes are above the car. They're gonna fall in the car.
Is that it?
Yeah,
you're
good.
You're free!
Oh, crap. I had to get number one before I lost it.
I was the first one to show up.
Oh, really?
They're like, what number do you want?
And that's
like,
something Stu knows story. About. You need something for the camera, like, on TV.
They saw that I was on USA Today. I'm kind of a big deal.
I'm kind of a big deal. I'm badass.
Product placement.
The one thing that I feel good about is ladybugs, in my opinion, are good luck, and there's ladybugs sitting all on the car. Get the ladybug. Zoom in on the ladybug. If they feel safe and they feel comfortable resting,
then you're okay with it.
Then we're okay. That means that's a good sign.
Everyone's like, why are you wearing a hat? It's like, well, I gotta wear some hat because when you're doing this, you sweat.
Yeah.
And then hat absorbs the sweat.
Yep. So when Nico Rosberg was in Formula One at Singapore, he used to put maxi pads. He would stick them to his forehead during the race so that it would absorb all the sweat.
Let's do this. Guess what? Time for you to change the oil. Let's do it. Deal with it.
The front drain plug is way the fuck under there.
It's at the front of the motor. See, actually, you almost might be better going at it from the side than from the back. Unless you want to crawl your entire body under there. But see, it's like... a little too far. Almost there. Hey, Eric.
Yeah.
Can you grab. So, what is that? That's 15. Grab the 13.
Scary. It's still not even touching.
Dude, you're fine. One of those jack stands can hold up the entire car.
Safety first?
Yeah. And we have four.
So, dude, don't ever watch anybody work on an airplane that you're about to fly on. You're fucking lose your shit.
Yeah.
I was working on a jet one night and the pilots come out just to look at it. I was whacking them. They were like, what the fuck are you doing, dude?
Like fixing it?
Don't worry about it. Go to the fucking side.
All right, about to try and break. There it goes. Sweet. Well, there's a secret surprise when you remove that bolt.
Secret? Really? I can't wait to see the surprise. Mongo like candy.
All right, let's see.
Okay. There's the thing.
Lefty loosen.
Yep. All right. And once you get a couple turns, it'll probably, you could probably hand spin it now. And then once it gets to the end, keep it pushed so that the threads are still engaged, and then just like move your hand out of the way as quick as possible, and it'll just fall into the grate. So there's a grate, so you don't have to worry about, just like let the plug fall. All right, ready? And then just go 1, 2, 3, pull. Perfect. Hey. Nice. Good job, man.
All right. I'm a professional.
Hey, can someone pull open the oil cap on top? So let's air in.
Where is it?
Up on top.
No, up top.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, much better.
That's better. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hi Todd. Yeah. Hey Dan, how you doing? Hey, congratulations on your article and your channel, dude. That's awesome.
Wait. Hold on, there it is. Yeah.
Hey,
did you know I got published on USA Today? You're fucked up. I would have never thought I got published on USA Today. All right, well that one's draining. We'll do some other stuff. Deal with it. Plug on yours is nowhere near the size of mine, so I don't think it's gonna be the torrential downpour.
Gotcha. Is this an Allen?
Yeah.
And how big is it? I had to buy a special 12. Bike. 12. Okay, same as mine. Yeah.
Mine's like 17 or something. No, it's fucking like that big in diameter. Yeah, it's like that. And when it comes out, it just goes.
Olio Motre.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Well, it says right on it, Olio
Motre.
Yeah.
Motor M O T O R E.
Yeah.
Olio. Like oleo margarine. Yeah, buddy.
Oh, it gives you the runs.
Oh, it's a different size.
Is it bigger or smaller?
Bigger.
Bigger? That red case right there should have a vacuum.
Oh, and Dan, I was telling them, I was like, I don't know if you recognize the Versa. It's been on the YouTube channel.
Oh, that's right. That's right. That Versa's famous.
All right, Dan, I'm going.
All right.
Hold my hand.
All right, cracked it loose, huh?
Cracked it loose.
Oh, no. Not too bad.
That fire is pretty warm.
That was a lot better than mine.
It's coming out jet black, yes. Texas tea.
Yeah, it's amazing how much oil these motherfuckers hold.
Next thing you know, Jed's a millionaire. Ten folks said, Jed, move away from there.
Said, California is a place you ought to be. So they loaded up the truck and they moved to Beverly Hills, that is.
There's Olio Motre in that motor.
I think I have another light somewhere if you want it.
Actually, his brake fluid doesn't look too bad.
Yeah, it looks pretty clean, actually.
Alright. Thank you. The drain plugs are out. It's draining. It just, I mean...
It just took us forever to get to that point.
Well, and it takes forever to drain the oil in these fuckers, because...
10 quarts is a lot of oil.
It's a lot of oil.
Change your breaker fluid while you're at it, too.
Here we go.
Fuck you, Todd.
And exhaust bearings.
Yeah, your muffler bearings are bad. Alright, we got new crush washer on. And actually, it looks like Stu actually got a kit that came with a brand new plug. So we might as well use the new plug. Screw it. It's all in perfect condition. So we're going to get these guys in there.
We need to find out what the torque specs are on these.
We tried to get the motive on his master cylinder and it's not going on. So, oil's drained. We got new fluid in the master cylinder. We got all the wheels off, so we're gonna crack the bleeders. New fluid in the master cylinder. So we're kind of like tag teaming this motherfucker. Everyone shut up. Like,
don't forget the outer and the inner.
Okay, yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you, thank you. Oh, look at you. Shh, shh. Quiet on the set.
Oh, you meant it was cool that everyone had shut up.
Yeah, yeah.
You were like, would you go to a little pizza court?
Well, no, it's kind of...
Cut.
Yeah. Hold on.
Scene over. All right.
Hold on,
you
I gotta redo this.
The garage.
Yeah, hold on. We'll do this again, Hold on.
Back to one.
Yeah, all right. So, no. Fuck that. All right, let's get these plugs in. Are you still whining?
Yes.
Ah.
With cheers. The new cups.
Cheers, yeah. Ladies. Oh, it's the new cups. All right, we gotta tighten down the oil bolts to 55 foot-pounds, so we'll do that real quick. Stu's got the oil out. That's a whole lot of oil in there.
That's a whole lot of
nastiness, huh?
Man, I can't wait to put on pancakes!
All right, go again.
Yeah, doing the old school pump and dump. Right, actually, it's kind of handy to just dump it right into there.
Okay, you're torquing.
55 foot-pounds is set.
55 foot-pounds per set.
All right, there you go. All
right.
Torque this bitch! Yeah, there you go.
Okay, and that was five more.
How boring is this?
You.
All right, we gotta top this off.
Get in there.
Professional pour he's got going here. Oh, he actually
does it. Yeah, the front's the same foot, 55 right, foot-pounds. I like this. I'm just running around like yelling at people now.
Okay.
Do stuff. I'm managing.
All right, that's the bottom. All right, that's two.
Okay.
All right, that's five. Let me switch it, and then we'll do five on the inside. And...
Okay. Yeah, it's definitely it's slowing up. Yeah.
I went down the road by my half a seat. I went down the road.
Hey, babe. How are you?
Good.
You
need some beer.
This?
No, I'm just recording it for. Hey, that's
I used to be
that's
cool.
Lucky. She's
Hi.
One of my awesome neighbors.
She's not gonna call the cops on us tonight.
Exactly.
So no. The night is young.
I'm partying too. Absolutely.
Actually,
you are
like the keystone of this cul-de-sac.
Thank you.
Like, she is.
Figuratively
so
and literally.
Yes. Well, we'll drink.
She makes this happen.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah.
It was a vacant hole when you left, and we were like. What the hell happened?
And then a dude moved into her house who had severe marital issues.
Yes, it was a
challenge.
Yeah, no, like you remember while they were in Boston, her family.
I'm not gonna record that part.
Daisy!
Hi, Daisy!
Daisy, girl!
Oh, Daisy!
What part of Boston were y'all living in?
And the bottom. And six. And the bottom.
Yay. You guys won't believe this shit, so.
It's a 360, yeah.
Yeah. All right, if you ever need to decide between a 360 and a 430, this is alone enough reason. So the oil filter? No, it's not underneath. It's not hanging down. No, it's dead center in the fucking valley, facing downward. It's right.
There's plenty of room.
It's under
the frame itself.
It's under there, like. Under there. Is that not the world's worst oil filter placement?
I'm not doing this for you again.
You gonna try
just,
it?
Just like your wife said. I'm not doing this for you again.
Oh,
burn.
Damn.
Wait, where's the filter wrench?
Tag, I'm
it. Yeah,
wait,
right here.
Okay, so Stu.
This is the worst motor ever. Sorry, Stu. I demand that you sell this piece of shit and buy a 458.
I will.
Okay.
And 3 years. Three years? I better hold Jeff steady.
Don't let Jeff fall to his death.
Oh, wait. Oh, I got it.
Is it going?
No, I mean, I got it on.
Do we have movement? I think we might.
Righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Oh yeah. I mean, thank you, Richard.
This is a nightmare.
It is.
The best part's gonna be all the oil's gonna dump all over everything.
Oh, speaking of which, did we have it set up on?
Oh, yeah,
we got the big one.
Let's align that. Oh, shit. Ow, my knee.
Why?
All right, we'll see. It's not that bad. The hardest thing is just getting locked. And yeah, you want to do it with a ratchet. You can get in there. The breaker's a little easier because you can angle the breaker in.
There's no way we're going to be able to figure out what torque.
Music to my ear.
Oh, yeah. Fuck, I don't know if we're going to. Yeah.
Torque wrench is huge.
Somebody want to give me a couple of rags, though, because I know from mine it's going to dump.
Hey, Eric. Yes. On that side, if the oil starts dumping below, can you realign the oil catch?
It's the only way I could be sure to get it, even if I let it drain for half an hour.
Look, Mom, I'm oil changing.
I feel like I'm having sex with your car, Stu.
I got an ass shot here.
It's not very good.
Give it.
Okay.
This is good. This is good content. Oh, jackpot!
All of it unusable.
Look at that!
Yay!
Wow!
Whoa! Didn't really drop any oil.
You fucker, you owe me.
Wow! That's amazing.
Damn, that's a big oil filter too.
It gave it birth.
Totally.
Does somebody want to lube this guy?
Yeah. Where's some? Get a
fresh oil.
New oil.
Yeah.
Just be careful not to cross thread that shit.
No, it's okay. It'll just be the filter he has for life.
5W40 quality Pennzoil for the European car in you.
Is there anything that isn't like an ad? Like, although you should have fucking Pennzoil. Let's get some revenue going.
I
from
know.
This
yeah.
Come on, Pennzoil. Please.
Pennzoil, come on, sponsor my ass. No, I've used about 30 of your fucking quarts. Lube it.
Yes.
Lube it.
Because I don't want too much on there. Since it's gonna drip everywhere.
Yeah, you.
Yeah. I know what I'm doing.
I know. It's sexy cam.
I can feel it. Oh. Let's get it on.
Oh, alright.
You came in really close, really fast. Jeff, just don't look back.
I'm not.
You'll be sad forever.
The really sad thing is that's not the first time in my life I've heard that.
Just don't look back.
although I drive a Ferrari. What's behind me
is
not
matter.
Important.
My anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hon.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm
you need some red beans and rice, yeah.
I'm a scrawny boy. That's just, you know. Actually, found it.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That was quick.
Look
at that.
Nice.
Man, you're a pro.
I would say we just hand tighten it because it's only 25 foot pounds.
Oh, really? Yeah, and actually, it didn't feel like it needed to break. He's hand tightened. Here is the light. We got all the rags out.
Yeah. Nice.
No, I don't need it. Like, we're gonna hand tighten it. Yay. Leave it hand tightened. We've got both the wrenches. Okay, so they're both
hooray.
Out. Okay.
All the fluids changed, right?
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah.
Pit stuff. Pit crew.
Just gotta put shit back together now.
Pit crew.
All right. Yay. We're almost there. Almost there.
Product placement.
Yeah. Come on, Pennzoil.
Pennzoil, sponsor Daniel Hurlburt.
Sponsor me.
Normal guy supercar.
I want to get sponsored, damn it. Look what my dog just did. Just slobbered the hell out of my car.
Nice.
Gosh.
Huh? Stay right behind it.
Yep.
Oh man, this is going to be a pain in the butt.
I don't have much room.
No.
Okay, wheels are torqued. Got 9 quarts in. We're going to drop the car down, put on the bottom panel. Then we got to warm up the car, wait for it to get warm, then check the oil. So again, for those of you that don't know, you check the Ferraris while they're running, while the oil's at temperature, because it's a dry sump, okay? And I know right now someone's gonna go, no, that's not true, you don't check the car while it's running. Go read a Ferrari's owner's manual and you'll see, it says right in there. Start the car, run it, you're supposed to like run it to like 3,500 RPMs for like 10 minutes or some stupid shit like that, but you just let it get warm. Anyway, yeah, see, he's all like, yeah, people. He's not lying, seriously.
What you do?
Because if you don't, you know what happens? If you do it while it's cold, or while the car's not running, and you top it off, then when you start the car, it's gonna flood it into the intake, and then it's gonna blow smoke like a motherfucker.
You gotta rotate it. Because the rear part's the diffuser part.
Yes.
Don't
No.
It's backwards.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, this has to go in the front.
No, this, that hooks in the front. That's the tail. This is the diffuser.
Yeah.
Do not question my authority.
And you will respect my authority.
Turning the Millennium Falcon around.
There you go.
Okay.
Yes, this Ferrari is worse.
This has a lot more going on with the oil change.
Yeah, it was a little more complicated.
360 is the worst Ferrari.
Oh. Eric, be my cameraman. Yeah.
Someday I'm gonna have a big garage. It's gonna be glorious.
Yeah. Right. Oh, that's kind of cool, actually.
Stu, I hate your car.
I know. This is way more difficult.
Yeah.
This whole car, the whole car is sticky.
Do you like a sticky start?
That's what she said.
Dude, do you like the sticky start?
It's almost there, Stu. So close. How you feel?
Good. It is on, and it's on right.
Yay. Oh, you got him? Nice. All right, we're all done. We gotta warm it up, get up the temperature, and then check the oil. That's gonna wrap it up. We're just waiting for the car to warm up. I put in 9 quarts. Once it gets warm, then we'll check it, probably add a 10th quart. The 360 is definitely a little bit more difficult than the 430. So the oil filter is kind of in the valley of the engine, which is kind of a pain in the ass. It really wasn't too bad. Jeff was able to get it off pretty easily. I think it wasn't tightened super tight, thankfully. If that sucker had been on there real hard, oh, that would have been really bad. The undercarriage tray on his car is way different and much more difficult to get in place. His drain plug is nowhere near as big as the 430, so it doesn't dump oil like crazy. So that was a big difference. Made it much easier to not make a complete mess. There you go, changing oil in the 360, not such a big deal. Changing the brake fluid, not such a big deal. All right, guys, I know you like seeing these sorts of things, so we'll be doing more car stuff, hopefully working on some cars. So give me a thumbs up, give Stu a thumbs up, give the guys a thumbs up. So we'll be doing more car stuff. We'll see you soon. It's gonna be sweet.